Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can create individual permission sets and how you can group those permission sets using permission set group. Right. So before starting, if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video and you will find links of various Salesforce related playlists. So you can follow them as well. So now moving to Salesforce and setup, first you need to search for permission set. So here you can see two options are available, permission sets and permission set groups. So first we need to create individual permission sets and then we can create permission sets groups. So the benefit is we don't need to assign individual permission sets then if we have created a group of permission sets. So I'm creating first permission set. So let's say case permissions, clicking on save. So here in object setting, I'm going to open case object and clicking on edit, and I will be enabling some of the permission related to case object here. So case record type, tab, read, create, edit permission, and permission for some fields. Yeah, so these I'm enabling for this case object. So I'm clicking on save. So on case object, I provided some permissions, add-on permission for this permission set, right? So one permission set is created as case permissions. Now I'm going to create one more permission set. So this I'm going to create for lead. So lead permissions. So here in object setting, I will be selecting lead object and I will be enabling some of the permission for lead object. So here is the lead object. So I'm opening this, clicking on the edit. So here also you can see various options are available. So I'm enabling both the record types. Here I'm providing read, create, edit, delete permission, then address, annual revenue, current generator, DOB, DNB company, email, email opt-out. So these permission I enabled. Now I'm going to save this permission set. So now if you want to assign both the permission set like case permissions and lead permission to some users, so for that purpose, you need to separately assign these permission sets. But now Salesforce is providing one more option, that is permission set group. So I'm opening it in another tab. So if we see the permission sets, so here you will see both, this is lead permissions and here we have case permissions. Now I opened permission set groups. So from here I can create new permission set groups, label case and lead permissions. Right. So these label and API names I'm using for demo purpose. So as per your requirement, you can put those things. So I'm clicking on save. So permission set group is created. Right. So now here we have two things, permission sets in group and muting permissions, muting permission sets in group. So from here you can view and manage permission sets in group. So first I'm going to explain this option and then we will cover this muting permission set in group. So I am choosing permission set in group, add permission sets. So I am selecting lead permissions and case permissions and I'm clicking on add. Done. So these two permission sets are added to this group. Right. So whenever you open this permission set group and click on this permission sets in group, so you can see how many permission sets are assigned to this group. right? Now, if we go to object settings, so now see, we are on permission set group, and I'm going to open object setting, and I'm going to open both case and lead objects. So on case, you can see read, create, edit permission is available, tab visibility is available, and field permission will also be enabled. So if I open the case, so here you can see I provided a record type a case demo one only, and read, create, edit permissions, and other permissions which I provided are also enabled, right? Now, if I see lead object in object setting, so here also you can see read, create, edit, delete, all four permissions are available. So this permission set group is having permissions enabled for both case and lead object, because two separate permission sets are part of this permission set group now, right? So this way you can assign permission sets to a group, and then now you can assign this permission set group to particular users. So you can click on this manage assignments, and you can assign this permission set group to particular users. So let's say I selected this user and I'm assigning. So both permission sets are automatically assigned to this user. So if I open this user, and if I scroll down, so here you can see permission set group assignment. So here we have individual permission set assignments, and here we have permission set group assignment. So this permission set group is assigned, and we open this, if we open this permission set group, so here we can check what permission sets are assigned to this group. So this way you can manage your permission set groups, right? Now, what is this? Muting permission sets and group. So let's say you assign two permission sets to this group and you want to mute some permissions. Like for this group, you want to disable some permissions, like those permissions won't be applied to the users who are owning this permission set group. But remember one thing, if you are muting permission from this group, then those permissions won't be muted through those individual permission sets. So individual permission sets are individual. So you can assign them individually as well, as they are part of this permission set group. So you can assign this group as well. But if you are muting permissions in this group only, so the permissions are muted in this group only, they don't reflect to individual permission sets, right? So if I click on new, save, opening this object setting. So let's say on lead object, I provided all four permissions. So I'm going to mute one permission. I'm muting delete permission. So here you can see a mute option is available. So I'm clicking on that, clicking on save. So it is saved. Now moving to muting permission set overview, and let's move to our permission set group that we created originally. And so here we have members in permission set group as permission sets, and here we have muting permission set in group. Now if I open this object, search for lead, so here you can see delete is removed because we muted that permission. So this way, if you assigned several permission sets to a particular permission set group, so you can mute some permissions as well. So those muted permission won't reflect individual permission sets. So if I open lead permission set here, and if I check object setting, so this is the individual permission set. So here on lead object, you will see all four permissions. But in permission set group, we muted delete permission from lead object. So that's why it won't be working for the users who are related to this permission set group, right? So these are two important options. So you can make a particular permission set member of this group. And if you want to mute any permission, you can do that as well. So I hope with this explanation, you understood how we can use individual permission sets and permission set groups. So remember one thing, if permission set is part of permission set group, then also it can be assigned individually to the users. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce related videos, so you can go to description of this video and you can find links of various playlists there. Thank you for watching this video.